good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Well, it's great to be here. It's an exciting day for Concord State University and the state of Maryland. You know, this year, the governor was proud to enact legislation to establish the Cyber Warrior Diversity Program here at Coppin, as well as four other Maryland colleges and universities. And I would like to say that I believe it was Senator Robinson who introduced that bill, and thank you very much for that. You know, this program will train students in computer networking and cybersecurity, including training that will work toward achieving a Computer Technology Industry Association certification. We will be providing $2.5 million each year to Maryland Higher Education Commission in their budget for grants to facilitate this exciting new initiative. Now, as was just mentioned, demand for skilled professionals in Maryland's cybersecurity sector is outpacing other areas of employment. And that's why we must do everything we can to make sure that we're tapping all the talent that is available here in Maryland. Now, we like to say that Maryland is the cybersecurity capital of the country, and in some cases, maybe the world. And we're proud to be home to some 70 federal laboratories, as well as many of the nation's premier cyber-related federal government agencies and military installations. We have the highest concentration of doctoral scientists and engineers in America. And we're third in the nation in research and development intensity, and second among the 50 states in the concentration of STEM employment. And just this year, Maryland was named the most innovative state in America. So to continue that leadership, you know, this year our administration has committed funding to the NMD social network technology platform, as well as the Maryland Technology Internship Program to encourage more internships in the technology sector to motivate Maryland companies to hire and retain the outstanding students that we're training right here in the state. And we recently enacted the Access Initiative, a $5 million investment to require our Maryland K-12 schools to offer computer science courses to our young folks. We also signed legislation into law that revised our current cybersecurity investment incentive tax credit to award tax credits to investors. And we're working very hard to create an unrivaled ecosystem in our state to serve this growing critical technology sector. So today, we're taking the next step in moving forward to make sure that we continue to be the cyber capital of the country and the world, and by making sure that we're reaching all of our potential and all the talent that is available here in the state. So I want to thank everyone who's been involved in this program, this innovative program here at Coppin, as well as the other HBCU schools and Baltimore City Community College. I want to thank Lance for all his work, and enjoy the rest of the day. Stay cool.